பிசி சார், நீங்கள் நல்லவரா கெட்டவரா?
ஐ எம் போத்.
Did you, were you inspired by Hollywood movies?
No, I was never inspired by Hollywood movies.
Hollywood are making the world of fools. Hollywood doesn't want people to think, yeah.
You were the, I mean, I would say the father of digital, because a long time
back. No, you can call me the grandfather. No, yeah, I'm the only student of digital.
I think PC Sriram is the most original craftsman, original cinematographer that there ever has been.
Mani is a good friend of from a childhood friend. I have no Astana cameraman to anybody.
Okay.
Because we consciously decided not to work together.
People say you are India's highest paid cinematographer.
Yes.
Are you the high?
The old system was that why should cameraman be paid so highly?
Because why should artists pay so highly? Tell me, sir.
So you feel that the artists should reduce their salary?
A wrong is a wrong wherever it happens.
Hello, everybody. I have with me PC Sriram. He is the guru of cinematography in India. He is a man who ushered in a new era into camera, into the cinematography. And the way he has evolved as a cameraman and the technique that he has brought across is something unheard in Indian cinema. Welcome to the show, PC, sir.
Thank you, Sriram. Thank you.
Sir, you have created a respectability for cameramen all over the world. I mean, before you came, let's say in the 80s and other period, cameramen were not looked up as much as the stars. But today, cameramen are stars by themselves. And you are responsible for it. Please tell us something about it, this great evolution that took place.
I can't take credit for anything which happened naturally. Huh. It's a natural evolution. I don't aim at getting the credibility or my approach to cinema is to see myself through every project the way I have not seen my previous film. So that's what maybe attracted the audience. And my job is not to impress anybody, but to feel happy when I feel satisfied. And also satisfaction cannot be 100%. So again, the next film starts and the next war begins.
Why have you stopped directing films? You had come out with good movies, if you really look at it.
Sometime back, I had the thought of not directing at all. But now I might direct one film, which is very personal. I don't know which language I'm going to do it. I've not even thought about it, but it might happen.
You are definitely going to direct it?
Yes, I'm going to direct a film. Yeah. I don't know when it's going to happen, but it will happen.
It will happen soon.
It's not soon, because next 2 years I'm busy with cinematography.
Sir, people say you are India's highest paid cinematographer.
Yes.
Are you the high?
No.
Why?
It has never been my priority, because I'll tell you why. Money is important in all aspects. When I came to the film industry after doing Mounaragam, I started my own advertising agencies called JS Films. Now it is called Real Image Media Technologies. We started doing our own ad films. And we at that time, after Nayagan, India was centric towards me. So I could get all the ad films to Chennai from Vimal, or shot in Chennai. So I was more into ad film area, maintaining along with my partner Jayendra. And Senzil, we were organizing our own thing. Now coming back to your question, and in today's thing, you can call me costly because there are a lot of people underpaid. The fact is different. You might say I might be costly. That's not correct, because the other side of the truth is they are all underpaid. There are people who are underpaid who deserve more.
You feel so?
That's a fact.
Because the old system was that why should cameraman be paid so highly? Because
why should artist pay so highly? Tell me, sir.
You know that artist will bring that opening for that movie. That is the reason. Yes. You also say that your camera may not bring people. You said in this interview itself that
it cannot get opening. Yes.
Yeah.
But there is a level. Yeah. But when the logical level changes, yeah. I don't want to give an example. Okay, one level is there. The budget, half budget going to the artist.
That is what's happening in Indian cinema.
That is wrong.
You are
depriving everybody of their economy. A wrong is a wrong wherever it happens.
So you feel that the artist should reduce their salary? What is your thing?
Be reasonable. I'm not asking anybody to be anything, whether it is Hindi or Tamil. I will charge more in Hindi because I will be deliberate.
Okay.
I will charge more in Hindi. I'm not saying that for sake of Hindi, I'm not saying that, but there should be some logic in the whole thing. Suddenly everything is going berserk because the volume of cinematographers have increased. You have no right to underpay anybody.
Yeah, but the cinematographers, like you said, there are far too many trying for the same pie.
Yes, but a time has come, everything will be. You have to respect, for example, everything is price fixed for the union, correct?
Yes.
If you don't pay, you can't shoot.
Okay.
Okay, like that, everything is happening in a process. Very soon, that process will also happen.
You feel, okay.
How it's going to happen, I don't know. Because if you don't pay a musician an amount which might be very heavy, by the evening after the, you cannot shoot. By the end of the day, if you don't pay the lightman, you cannot shoot.
You are the president of the Cinematographers Association.
Yeah, I am the president of SICA, but I am not talking in as a representative. I am talking as a cinematographer. There should be a level where when you, yes, I am the highest paid cinematographer. Yes.
You agree.
I agree. But there's another point. When you see that point, then it look as if I am the.
What you are saying is others also should be well paid.
Because they are low, they are not that paid. It looks as if I am overpaid.
Okay.
You got my point.
Yeah.
And according to the project only, I certain films I have not taken. For example, Money is okay. Company, we worked a very strict budget. What is needed for that money? Film only, I took the money.
Okay. So you,
for example, a film called Mugam, which was shot for 10 days, I didn't take any money.
Okay.
There are things, me and Mani did films for Manu Raghav. We know that we worked, we didn't work for the sake of money, but little money only we took. That's how I have been brought up in this film culture. My family is not from films. Whatever I learned is through this. This project I can afford because I have given the liberty to my directors like Mani and Balki to tell me, hey, in the project you are not going to do it. That is how I am transparent about. Whereas Balki in one film will say this, I can give you. In another film, Ki and Ka, sorry boss. That's how it's healthy should be. Don't take things for granted, communicate and make a way. So I am the costliest, I am also available for no cost.
That's good, a good explanation.
Yes, because I have done films like that and I have, in my initial days, not a lot of producers never paid me any money, but that is not the criteria. I have gone through the whole process.
तो आपने कब तय किया कि आप घर फुल टाइम संभालेंगे?
Now what do you see the changes coming into cinematography? They are saying in Hollywood they will have robot cameramen, robotic cameramen.
Anything is possible here. Hollywood are making the world of fools.
Why are you critical about Hollywood so much?
Hollywood doesn't want people to think. Yeah, they are mass products. See, if you take French cinema, any cinema, what's happening is, I enjoy a film like Jungle Book, well made, okay, I enjoy it, fine. You can't keep doing that old Hollywood had other shades of cinema. Not only this kind of destruction, 120, 20, 12, 20, 10, only this mass dinosaur coming and killing the world. World is going to dry, one digital pen will come and if you put it, that will make you give you extra digital files. I can write anything I want. But people should think. One generation has been grown without thinking, thanks to Hollywood.
Okay, but they got also the latest technology.
That's why they did. See, America can make the whole world of fools, no? They're making us fools. French cinema never takes you for a ride. If you see a French cinema or any cinema, it will make you think. When we grew up in a different kind of cinema. I am scared of another generation seeing only this robotic thing living in. And already it's a digital world. You should have human emotions in every human body. Not only digital emotions.
So the human behind the camera is also important for you.
Yes, humanity, human is very important. Don't digitalize even humanity. Put this digital thing, you'll become human. Put this little bit, no.
No, okay. What are your references? What keeps you abreast of others? I mean, do you read a lot or do you?
I used to read a lot, not now. Human relationships, observing human relationships is most important.
For you, as a you would give what are the kind of advice you would give to young people?
I take advice from young people. Who are we to advise anybody? I told a point of view. Don't make the next generation think, not by only making 2012 and anacondas, and they already have only video games. Nothing. I'm not against video games. I'm saying along with that, give a balance their lifestyle. I'm not saying take away technology. Technology is a must.
Must.
Balance your technology. If you go to France, they have balanced their life. My niece is from Sweden. I could say their life so balanced. My niece is married to a Swedish guy. And my nephews and all are so balanced in their life about nature, about video games. They are from the European countries. I could see a healthy balance. Whereas the same here, I could see people only in front of the computer. They are living in constant virtual space. When I see my nephew who had come for shooting, they enjoy life. They go for hunting. Hunting means because their city is like, country is like that. One house, another house is so far away. And they are also into the games. And I find a very balanced life. I think that is very important. Technology is very high there. But there is a human balance.
Timing बहुत खराब चल रही है. Kiss my ass monkey.
How is your chemistry with certain directors like Mr. Mani Ratnam and PC Sriram? You were in the earlier 80s and 90s. People called you the Astana cameraman of Mani Ratnam at one time. So how does the director cinematographer relationship work? Just tell me. And now with Balki, you're having...
No, Mani is a good friend from a childhood friend. I have no Astana cameraman to anybody.
Okay.
Because we consciously decided not to work together.
Okay, but you have produced some of your
best
works.
No, I'll tell you, after three films, we decided not to work together. Nobody will take those kind of decisions. After Geetanjali, both of us sat and said, we will part. Because somewhere you become dependent on me, I become dependent on you. It's not good for each other. Yeah. Nobody else, because me and Mani, it's a big story. We started our career going behind producers. At one point of time, I said, you go your way, I go my way. We'll meet when the time comes. After Puve Poochadova, he called me. And I did Mauna Ragam. I told Balki, let's give a gap now.
But his next film also you are doing?
I am doing. Yeah. But I told him, let's give a gap now. That's good for both of us.
Okay. You don't want to be closely identified with...
Not identified. I am not bothered about what other people think. What happens is, two people on a longer run together, as a director, thinks you tend to take things for granted. In cinema, you cannot do that.
Okay.
So you are walking on the wire always.
Okay.
He's done a good job, Chini Kampa. Those things should not continue in the next film.
People have called P.C. Sriram a genius, a master craftsman, a guy who's redefined cinematography, a man whose name attracts coins on screen. All these, and he's been called many, many bigger names. But I think P.C. Sriram is the most original craftsman, original cinematographer that there ever has been. Because for him, it's not about getting it right. It's not about just telling a story. It's about telling a story in a way that has not been done before. It's about getting it right, about expressing an emotion. It's about communicating a thought or a story in a way that's not been done before. Each time, he wants to do something original. There are very few people in this in a world where originality is at a premium and where very little credit is given to originality, and people are kind of just worried about just the commercial prospects of any story that they're telling, regardless of whether it's been told before or whether it's been done the same way before. P.C. Sriram has never lost that sense of originality. He's always, it's not just his language, it's not just his style. Each time he has tried to, express himself differently. Of course, everybody has a signature, everybody has a way of doing things. But in that way, P.C. has always tried to find an original way. And there are very few craftsmen left in the industry, in fact, in many, many industries, who believe in the power of originality as much as P.C. Sriram does. For that, I salute him. For that, I'll always be his fan. And for that, he's got to put up with me for the rest of his life.
You are at ease with young directors also, like Mr. Bhakya Raj of Remo.
That's basically my real age is that. That's why I'm able to coordinate it with everybody. Physical age might be different. But my real age, I'm able to...
So suppose if a young director comes up to you and says, sir, I got a script.
Lot of people are there. Only thing, they don't come with a good producer.
Your producer is most important than
no,
this?
No, unless you are produced, who is going to produce it? My name is, just by putting my name, asking me, does not bring a producer. I am not responsible for the project.
Do you go through the script before finalizing a film?
Yes, definitely.
Do you insist on a bounded script?
Yes, yes. You can see Ramo bounded scripts. Before, Mani and me never used to have bounded scripts because we used to discuss.
Yes.
We used to discuss everything. We used to write on a paper, on the last minute something. Then the set, you'd ask me, what did I tell you? What did I tell you? We'll go. That was a time was
different. Sir, you have created lighting in cinema, in commercial cinema, in the sense that you made it fashionable. Would you tell us, see, you started in one of your best lighting works, for me personally, is Agni Nachatra. How did you start it? Why did you feel at that particular time? It's a pakka commercial film, but that worked wonders at the box office, mainly because of the lighting and the way the film was packaged.
When me and Mani were discussing about it, we wanted to go berserk in storytelling because something along with Mani's screenplay, something has to hold the interest. See, when you're going something, you should have the director along with you. And a guy like Mani gets the best out of me because he lets out the madness out in me, okay? Unless the director is in the comfort zone, it cannot go forward. Because Mani was in the comfort zone of me doing it, I kept on taking it up and up and up and up and up and up. Raja, Raja di Raja di Raja, Pooja, Chiyali Kurragaru Pooja. After that film, when I did a film called Tevar Magan, I realized I was doing it for the film, I was removing all the colors in the frame area to justify that story. It was more of a monochromic film.
But wasn't Tevar Magan an outdoor film, basically?
Even an outdoor, so much of work was done. Colors were removed. Now you can remove it digitally. There you have to ஃபிசிக்கலி ரிமூவ் இட். ரோட்டில் தார் இருந்ததுன்னா ஃபுல்லாக மணல் கயிறை போட்டு மறைச்சி எல்லாத்தையும் பண்ணி சேரெல்லாம் போட்டு ஐ வாண்டட் அ மோர் ஆஃப் அ ப்ரௌன் டோன். ஆக்டர்ஸ் காட் லிட்டில் பிட் டயர்ட் வாக்கிங் டே அண்ட் அவுட் ஆஃப் த சேரு அண்ட் ஆல் பிகாஸ் தட்ஸ் அ டைம் ஏரியா வி சோஸ். சம் பீப்புள் செட் ஐ வாஸ் வெரி சர்ப்ரைஸ்ட் பை அ திங், யூ ஆர் நாட் தேர் இன் த ஃபிலிம். ஐ செட் தட்ஸ் வேர் ஐ ரியலைஸ் ஐ ஆம் டூயிங் இட் ஃபார் த ஃபிலிம், நாட் ஃபார் மீ.
PC, you are also known for your urban chic-looking movies, but at the same time, you haven't. Have you really done a film deep down in the villages of India? I mean, or Tamil Nadu, where I think only after Theva Magan you have.
I have done only one film, village film. I don't know anything about village.
Okay.
I don't know anything about village. Yeah. If I say I know, I will be saying through what I have read in from books. And what I have seen in films, that is not knowing. Being there is all about, because going back to Thevar Magan, the location, the house, whatever I chose was wrong. Was wrong. And I realized it when Kamal told me certain things, and I said, stop. I want to know the history of the whole thing. Because I don't know the history. Without history, you can't do anything. I said, stop. And Kamal, you know, is a good friend. He's open-minded and all those. So he brought somebody who told me the whole story of that happening, which I am not aware. And I'm a city boy guy, and my knowledge about all these things are it's only through literature, only through Tamil books.
Okay. So you feel that a cameraman also should be well read about what the subject that he's dealing with?
I think it's important. I'm not saying it's a must, it's important. And I remember when that film was released, when I had the projection in Prasad, we used to check the prints. And there was another film coming, another film also was parallelly coming, which had songs and all. They will project that film, everybody will come and watch. The moment they will start this film, everybody will go off. I said, this is my success. Because they are conditioned to mind what they want. Okay, I don't know why, because I have gone through the whole film process. Not as a cinematographer, from the whatever is happening. Because they are right in the sense they don't know what is what. It's like a documentary song. La 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 la. It's not even commercial. How to do this, how to do that. But there is some other truth which is going to hit.
Would you say that so many cameramen have come up and the number of production of Tamil cinema has gone almost to 200 every year? Is this part of the digital age, or what happened? When you started off with celluloid and
See, this question has been asked day in and day out, not only in Tamil, in Guantanamo Bay or anywhere else in the world. The answer is simple. Before, there used to be only one camera to capture. Either it's a motion picture film camera. The moment it shifted to digital, various modes were created. As sports cameras created, this is created. A vast things were created. Naturally, outputs are more. See, there was a time when pen was for first time, and pen was made all over the world. Pen was available to the common man. He started writing, but what he wrote might be great to him, but what stays in the longer run becomes a great part of literature.
Okay.
Because before that, everybody did not have a pen. Film will be an art only when everybody has got access to camera. Now
it's an art. That now what you feel you're, that it's much better for the
it's
industry.
It's the best time in the world. Don't say everybody has got everything. Everybody must have everything. That process The process will make things better.
Now, you did the last, your last celluloid film was I.
Yeah.
And then you made now Remo totally in digital.
No, I made Shamita also in digital, Key and Ka also in digital.
Key and Ka, okay. So, three films you did in digital. So, but you were the, I mean, I would say the father of digital because a long time back.
No, you can call me the grandfather. No, yeah, I'm the only student of digital. It's not well, that.
You know, you started off with your own Banam.
Yeah, that is, curiosity kills the cat, man. That's what I did. My the sense, take it, the curiosity is kills the cat in the sense that technology or something is just happening in the world. I always feel I have insecurity, I should not be left alone. So that's the fifth digital film.
So around 20, 25 years back you did digital.
Yeah, but it was the initial stages. Every time I had to ask a Japanese never had an answer.
No.
At the end, what happened, I took care of one side and left the other side completely out. Technical side I took care, as a director I miserably failed. Because so much of for everything, you have to go through 101 obstacles. Yeah. That cable, this cable, this cable. Then Delta, talk to Japan. This is the fifth film on HD.
But
as a director, I failed miserably. A good story.
Yes. But are you more comfortable now than when you were earlier working with film rules?
Yeah, I'm comfortable with technology because any growth, there are plus and minus points in every areas.
Okay.
But to me, the plus point is creativity.
Creativity
is what determines art. Technology is secondary.
No, a lot of people say now, when I see the DI of I, and when you see the DI of Remo, is there some difference between both?
Yes. See, you don't have to under one thing. People are confused and stuck in the good old days. When you come to digital cinema, your digital cinema is complete only with the DI.
Yes.
Please be very clear. When you shoot on film, it's all locked.
Yes.
Here it is not locked like film. What I had in my mind in my film of any film you can call is in my mind. If I want to enhance it, I can do it in DI. That is the beauty of the technology. Don't admire the artist who has done it. Don't criticize it for some other reason you are not capable of.
Tell me, in Remo, you made Shiva Karthikeyan look so beautiful. That Remo character, what I mean. Is it also because of digitally you have... color processing was excellent.
Yeah, I'll tell you. See, thanks to technology, for example, the number of tests we did. See, there are certain things which is my call which makes it look like that. If my call is wrong, everything will go wrong. See, when you have Kirti Suresh and Shiva Karthikeyan next to each other, I should feel comfortable is my thing. If I don't feel comfortable, nobody else will feel comfortable. To me, I had done a lot of work on that, my groundwork, which everybody does their groundwork, personal work.
Yeah.
I had followed that work very meticulously, certain methods for Remo's look. That homework really worked. If I had missed this side or that side, gone. The believability level, I was happy. I was very scared.
But you're happy with it?
No, I'm happy. It took 2 months for me in the lab. 2 months for me to do the pre-production work and do the lighting and later to give the final touches, which is also done digitally today. Don't say they did it digitally.
PC sir, you have been involved in some of the most romantic films in Indian cinema. You take right from Maunaragam to Remo. How is it that you are associated with good, soft, romantic movies, which people like? Your thoughts on that?
Maybe outwardly, I'm not a romantic person. I'm trying to be romantic through my camera. That's it.
So tell us about these romantic things in Remo.
See, the thing, first thing, one thing is, which is so nice to work. Feel, they make you comfortable in all aspects. People complicate things for no reason. And people like Raja makes it life more beautiful. And Shivakarthikeyan was the same. To me, I met him and when I was working with him, he was so. And I could see that when you gel with people, that when you harmonize with people, it's blessed. Like how I had to shoot Vikram was ugly in I as a beautiful guy.
Yeah, that's why don't you just give us a contrast between Vikram as an ugly person in I, you have to show him in that particular character, and Shivakarthikeyan as a beautiful. How do you compare both?
No, ugly has to be shot beautifully, yeah.
Beautifully?
No, yeah, because people have the sense of being very aversive. Takkunu paaka pidikada paaka maatanga. Reason is, on the board, when he is running in all the body language, where he has to take revenge, it has to be that.
Yes.
Nothing else has to be there. Mm. But when he sees the thing, Rumbanai or Munji Pakamudia than Mari. Rumbanai Pakamudia, the Papa. That's why I felt the ugly should be shown as a beauty to whatever level I can do.
Sir, what about social media? You yourself are very strong on Twitter.
Yes.
How is your experience on social media?
Social media, I am talking about certain, I have not started tweeting much about nowadays. Before I used to tweet about a lot of social issues. That's my point of view, okay? Social media, but when it comes to reviewing about film, when a film is good, when Thangam Engal was beautiful, I said it was good. When Moolar Kudam was good, I said it's good. When Joker, I told Rajamurugan, I will not talk to you till I see the film. I saw the film and then spoke to him because he said so much of social relevance is there. But you might ask me, but I am a cinematographer, whoever gives me a job, I will go. And that's the way it is, okay? But as a film goer, these things, I loved those films. So the cover, I immediately liked the film, I reacted. And that created an impact which I never knew that will create an impact.
Hey, yeah, a person like you appreciating a film would definitely create.
Because Moolar Kudam was a black comedy. I was laughing in the theater because only in Tamil cinema it can happen, suddenly shift to a dark humor. Ingada and the humor in the extreme.
See, it was lovely talking to you. So many things you have put forward.
I've been seeing your interviews a lot.
Yeah, I mean, I loved doing this interview. And one last thing, keep going till the end. Keep going, doing good films.
Yes.
And you should remain, I mean, the way that what you are.
I will always be there. Okay.
Thank you.